That's good, man.
I'll tell you what. Yeah. But now the world's different, George, and people don't know each other. They don't trust each other.
I get 20 robocalls a day, Paul, on my cell phone. 20 calls a day from solicitors and salespeople, and unbelievable. Or you get phony emails from your bank. You call your bank and say, is my account okay? And they went, of course, there's nothing wrong with it. And I explained the email, and they said, you didn't fill anything out, did you? And I went, no, heck no. And they said, thank God. That's the whole trick, to get your information.
Unbelievable time we're in. And think about it, George. If you look at it from a prophecy standpoint, when you look at it from a biblical standpoint, if you believe in Satan, if you believe in the dark side, he's from the very beginning, you know, when he was a serpent and there he was on in the Garden of Eve, he was saying, look, I want to make your life better. I want you to be more knowledgeable like God is. And just trust me and let me lead you to the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And, you know, in a lot of ways today, I try to talk to teenagers. I've got grandkids now. I've got 7 grandkids now. And I'm saying to them, knowledge is great, but you have to understand how to perceive it. You need to know how to discern it. You got to watch out because not everybody out there has your best interest in mind.
That's right. And you got to learn how to use it.
That's right. So we're still there. We're still in the garden. It's coming at us from different different forms and shapes. And we've got to know how to use the technology. Technology is wonderful. I can tell you, I love the YouTube. I love the internet, radio. I love radio. I remember listening to you all the time, driving in the middle of the night. And I would be going to work, driving 5 hours through the middle of the night.
When you were a kid.
Yeah. And I wasn't a kid then. 15 years ago, let's say that. And I would think to myself, this is great. That this advancement in technology as far as just radio itself. So when you think back and you look at all the things that we've gone through, what does the future hold? Well, I know I'm called the doom and gloom guy, but I'm not really. I'm a guy who understands from the scriptures and practicality that you have to evolve, you have to change as times change. But you have to also keep yourself grounded, and you have to keep yourself focused on what's right, what's wrong, and protect your families and protect yourself. And you can do this with God's help. It's a great life, if it's the end days.
And isn't the end days kind of a misnomer? Because don't things get better after a certain time?
Yes, it does. When we get to the millennial reign, there's 1,000 years. The Bible talks about Christ shall reign 1,000 years. There is going to be an unbelievable better time. But it's sort of like the old saying, it's got to get worse before it gets better.
Yeah.
And we're in that period right now of the birthing pains of a new age. And we got to get through this, okay? So we're in the emergency. Look, we're in the delivery room now, George. And the contractions are about a minute apart. It's getting close.
I got to tell you, this is hilarious, Paul. A couple, a year ago, when they started putting up plastic sheets between the bartender and you sitting at the bar or a restaurant, they had these things floating in the air with a little string attached to them, and then they had another one right next to it with about a 2-inch gap, and another one, and another one, and another one. So the entire place had this plastic around there, and then between the tables at the restaurant, they had a little plastic stanchion that was sitting there, even though you could put your hand around it and shake hands with the person at the table behind you. And I said to myself, this doesn't work. This is such a waste of time and money and energy. Today they came out with a story that said the plastics industry has jumped by almost $750 million because of the pandemic and these funny little plastics that they put up, and that there's no survey ever that says that they stop any kind of virus at all. Of course not. It could even go under, it could go on the side, it could go over. It's not going to stop it. How could people fall for that, Paul?
You know, I thought about that a lot. I'm glad you bring it up, because it was a it's this illusion that, well, maybe if there's a plastic screen between me and you, I'll be safe, you're safe, we, you know, there's a little something between us. It's like a force field. I don't know, we thought we were going to bring in, you know, some kind of force field, some kind of a super hero type mentality. People fell for it. It was a false sense of security. I think a lot of times the mask was the same thing.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
You know, and so, you know, at some point people finally started waking up and saying, oh, wait a minute, this isn't working. Is it? And I kept asking, does the virus float in the air? Is it aerosol? What is it? And nobody, to this day, no one ever explained to me what really, how it could, you know, touch. I understand that maybe. But really, I think people just wanted to sell, they wanted some kind of comfort, some kind of something that made them feel like maybe I'm safer.
Right, and this place is actually doing something for me.
Right, right. And like maybe by doing this, at least everybody's trying. Hopefully this will work. You know, it's a false sense of security, and it's a lot of it was just hoping. Without it, people had no hope. So, wow. But this is, we turned the corner now, George.
Absolutely.
We turned the corner, and I think you're going to see a different world. And I pray to God every day, Lord, we don't need another outbreak of any kind. But unfortunately, according to Scripture, this is just the beginning.
Let's talk about that, Paul, when we come back after the break. Paul Begley with us, the pastor. His website is linked up at coasttocoastam.com, paulbegleyprophecy.com. It's all linked up for you. We'll come back and talk more about end times prophecy. And, of course, next hour, we open up the phone lines and you can talk with them, too.
To access the audio archives of Coast to Coast AM, log on to coasttocoastam.com.
Newsroom. Four Glendale police officers are on leave after a video went viral showing them punching and kicking a man on the ground during a rough arrest. An internal investigation is underway. A veteran Garden Grove police officer faces up to 4 years in the Orange County Jail if he's convicted of charges related to beating and threatening homeless people while on duty. Body cam footage shows him beating homeless men on at least two occasions. A contract worker who allegedly stole hundreds of blank vaccination cards from an LA COVID-19 mega site is facing felony charges. The man from Las Vegas allegedly stole more than 500 cards, which have a street value of at least $7,500. Southland weather from KFI, sunny today, breezy at the coast, temps in the mid-80s in the valleys, mid to upper 70s for LA, OC, and the IE metros. The upper 60s at the beach, warmer tomorrow. Right now, 58 in Buena Park. Newport Coast is 56. Culver City, 58. And in Calabasas, it's 50 degrees. We lead local from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Phil Hewlett.
Taking your way to Anaheim, northbound 7-5 before Lincoln. Wreck of the right shoulder. CHP's on the scene. They're taking the right lane. You ride a little heavy coming away from Disneyland Drive. They're running a break in Santa Fe Springs. Southbound 605 before Slauson. Working to clear a solo car spin out of the carpool lane. Little sluggish here from Washington. A full closure in Burbank. Southbound 5 all lane shut down from Scott Road to Verdugo for a Caltrans project. Seeing a little slowdown coming off of Buena Vista. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Ryan Duggan.
Dean sharp here. Nothing disrupts your life, your comfort, even your safety like a power outage. And outages are the new normal. So now is the time to set up your home with an emergency generator from Duffy Power. Duffy is Southern California's generator experts. And with 0% interest financing, emergency power totally affordable. Duffy Power, making sure your life, your comfort, and your safety are not to be interrupted. Dial #250 on your cell and say Duffy Power. #250, Duffy Power, or on the web at DuffyPower.com.
Getting families vaccinated against COVID-19 is an important step to bringing back joy for all of us. That's within reach now that the Pfizer vaccine is proven safe and effective for those 12 and older. This is the same vaccine millions of Californians have already gotten. California is even adding new vaccine clinics specifically for young people. Together, we can end the pandemic. Visit VaccinateAll58.com or call 833-422-4255 to learn more. It was a beautiful June morning in Southern California.
Birds were chirping, the sun was shining.
And somewhere on a quiet residential street, a sink was clogging.
The couple experiencing the clog,
Mr. and Mrs. JP,
did something they had never done before. They called the Smell Good Plumbers at Mike Diamond. I'm Mike Diamond. I guarantee my plumbers will show up on time and unclog your sink for $99.
A technician showed up promptly and unclogged the sink.
A few months later, a much more intensive problem turned up in the bathroom.
Mr. JP called Mike Diamond again. They worked up a plan and the repair was made.
Mr. and Mrs. JP felt good enough about the experience to sit down and write us an email.
They commended the Smell Good Plumbers on their service and closed by saying they would use Mike Diamond on future services and recommend them to anyone in need of plumbing repairs.
We love Mr. and Mrs. JP, and we'd love for you to read their testimonial and more before calling your next plumber. The address is MikeDiamond.com, or just call us at 1-800-446-MIKE. Contractor's license number 399-170.
KFI AM 640. More stimulating talk.
What we're talking about is the crazy, mentally ill, drug-addicted, alcoholic lunatics on the street that are terrorizing everybody.
And they've done nothing for those people.
They just took care of the easy stuff.
But the difficult stuff, they haven't even tried.
John and Ken, weekdays 2 to 6 on KFI.
Next hour with Pastor Paul Begley as we talk about end times prophecy. ParanormalDate.com keeps cruising along. 737 people shy of 112,000 members. Free to sign up. ParanormalDate.com.
And let's say you're 60 plus and you want someone just a bit more mature. Well, guess what? We have you covered there as well. Go to ParanormalDate.com/seniors. There you'll find folks that are 60 plus and people that think like you do. So check it out. ParanormalDate.com/seniors.
And maybe before you go on that date, try this.
Instant beauty, stunning results that best describes instantly ageless. a velvety micro cream applied lightly on forehead wrinkles, eyebrows, under eye bags, crow's feet, facial pores, and hooded eyes. Within minutes, skin is tight and smooth, no needles, no pain, and great for women and men. Here's what people are saying about Instantly Ageless.
I've probably noticed in the past 5 years that my eyes have gained a lot of fine lines, wrinkles, my crow's feet have gotten deeper. Wow, I was hoping for 5 years, but that's like what my eyes looked like 10 years ago.
That is really cool. Wrinkle gone?
It's easy, just put it on your finger and go.
Now I wish I had more down here because I can still see one wrinkle, it's bugging me.
I am a little bit emotional. I'm turning 40, I didn't think would be a big deal to me, but that looks like the me that I feel like inside instead of what I see when I look in the mirror.
Instant results with Instantly Ageless. Now Instantly Ageless is shipped for free with smart delivery. Just use discount code George. If you would like to sample Instantly Ageless, order our hassle-free starter kit with free shipping for only $19.99. Instantly Ageless is not available in stores, so order today at healthylooking.com. That's healthylooking.com. Or by phone, 800-604-3129. 800-604-3129, 24/7. Instantly Ageless from healthylooking.com.
I want to talk with you for a moment about Birch Gold. In April alone, consumer prices increased by 4.2%, the highest bump since 2008. Higher fuel prices fueled it. Food prices as well, construction costs, housing prices, inflation just isn't coming. It's already here. And if you haven't diversified into some precious metals yet, you're leaving your savings exposed. Birch Gold Group is the one to trust to convert an IRA or eligible 401 into an IRA backed by gold and silver. That's right. Through a little-known tax loophole, you can convert your retirement savings that's tied to the stock market into an IRA backed by precious metals. It's your hedge against inflation, and you can even buy physical gold, have it delivered right to your door. Get your free information kit on precious metal IRAs by going to birchgold.com/coast. With thousands of satisfied customers, an A-plus rating with a Better Business Bureau, and countless five-star reviews, Birch Gold can help you hedge against inflation as well. Go to birchgold.com/coast and invest in gold before it's too late. Birchgold.com/coast.
Hi, me again. I want to turn you on to a path to feel better, have more energy, and less sickness. It's a great website, criticalhealthnews.com. The audio lectures, videos, and articles about health will captivate you, you'll see. CriticalHealthNews.com features content from world-class alternative health experts who make a lot of sense, and they'll earn your respect and admiration after you take their advice and try the recommended unique products designed to work in concert with your body to provide all the nutrition it needs. Log on to CriticalHealthNews.com and take advantage of all the free health information available there. Remember, education is your best defense against sickness and misery. Get inspired by visiting CriticalHealthNews.com, where you can purchase modular nutrition packs and see for yourself how good you can feel.
Call 1-855-949-RADIO or 1-855-949-7234. Welcome back to Coast, George Norrie with you, along with Pastor Paul Begley. Paul, with us being in the beginning of the end times, how long will the process take before you would really say, we're in this thing now?
I think this decade, between now and I really believe the arrival of the asteroid of Apophis.
Yeah,
2029. I think Apophis is going to come so close. And even if it don't hit us, the companion asteroids that come along with it,
the little ones,
we're going to get hit with no doubt two or three or four of these fragments or smaller ones. According to Revelation 8, there's two deep impacts we're going to encounter. One is going to hit apparently the ocean, We're going to wipe out about a third of the ships in the sea and a lot of the marine life. And the second one that will hit the land somewhere, creating a ton of radiation that creates the wormwood effect to our aqueducts and to the rivers and freshwater. So this decade, we're going to see a lot, and we're just getting started. The 2021 is the beginning of a 10 years of apocalyptic events.
Why are so many celestial events tied into end times?
Well, you know, in the Genesis chapter 1, George, in the 14th verse, God says that he made the sun, the moon, the stars for signs and seasons and for days and years. So the calendar, obviously, but signs, prophetic signs and seasons. So from the very beginning, and as far as the biblical narrative is concerned, these signs in the heavens are to show us not only what year we're in and how to keep track, but prophetically watch these. For instance, we're getting ready to have a solar eclipse, and this solar eclipse that's going to happen is right in the middle between the two that cross America. The one we had on August 21st, 2017, that crossed America, which is amazing, from Salem, Oregon to Salem, South
Carolina. Yeah, that was something to be part of.
Yeah, really, you can't. And now the other one, George, is going to come April 8th, 2024, which will crisscross the Earth, meeting in Carbondale, Illinois. And I think that's a portal for sure, because when you look at Carbondale, Illinois...
It's right by St. Louis.
Right by St. Louis. There's another little town 10 minutes away called Cairo,
yep,
Illinois. There's three pyramids within 100 miles of Carbondale. And even the Southern University, Southern Illinois University's mascot is the Seleucus, which is the dog of the pharaohs. It's like...
You can't make this stuff up.
No, you can't. I mean... We're going to see more signs. Okay, so we got these blood moons, we have these solar eclipses, and the Bible says there will be, you know, the sun will be darkened, the moon will turn to blood before the great and terrible day of the Lord will come. So I think God is sending us signs so that we can say, okay, things are happening. What's going on? And everybody starts looking up, and the Lord says, well, let me show you something. I told you these things were going to come. I'm going to correspond them with signs in the heavens to help you understand that the end of the age is near, and I thought, you know, that Christ is going to come, and I want you to prepare yourself for such a change that's about to take place.
Let me throw out these 10 possibilities, Paul, that could include itself into end times prophecy, and tell me if you think they are or not and what they might be. One, the famines. How do they play a role?
Absolutely. You know, the Bible talks about it in Matthew 24, that there will be famines, pestilence, and all these other things. Famines, even right now, the United Nations says that 957 million people, about a billion people across 93 countries, don't have enough food to eat. And we're getting ready to go through a really bad year this year, George. I mean, the West Coast of America itself has never been so low on water. They shut the canal down for the first time in 127 years. They're not going to let the water flow through California, where 25% of our vegetables are grown.
They need the water. Like meat is way down.
Meat's way down. Okay, so from the pandemic, our food chain, our entire supply chain was disrupted, and now we're trying to crank it back up again, and as we're doing that, we have droughts. We have famines. And here's one thing. The Bible tells us in the book of Hosea, the Lord says, I will rain on one city, but not two other cities. And the people in those two cities will migrate to the one city for water, but there still won't be enough. These are part of the signs that the famines that are coming are just getting started. I'm going to make a prediction for you, George. I hate to say it.
Okay.
This is the beginning of this decade, from 2021 till a Apophis. So the prophets arrive, you're going to see the famine get worse and worse and worse, and the need for food will get outrageously desperate, and we're going to come up with alternative foods. And I think you're already seeing the world do that.
Next up, pestilences.
I'm getting ready to have a cicada explosion here in West Lafayette, Indiana.
They're everywhere.
So here they come.
Somebody had a car accident. They hit his window and he couldn't see and got into a car accident.
Oh, yeah. They're huge. I remember them when I was a child, when I was 8 years old, and again at 25, again at 42, and here they come again. It's going to be, and get this, the president's plane, well, actually the press that was going to fly with President Biden, they couldn't even get off the ground. Washington, D.C., the swamp is invaded with smoke.
Too many got sucked into the engine.
Yeah, who ever heard of such a thing?
It's crazy.
And look what the locusts have done, George, in the last 3 years. In North Africa and the Middle East, Yemen, Saudi Arabia.
Well, they're eating all their crops, and they don't have that many anywhere.
Exactly. And look at the mice in Australia. Have you ever seen anything like this in your life? I mean, it's insane what's going on there. So, yeah, we're in a different world, and they're only going to get worse, according to biblical prophecy, more and more pestilences, which create diseases, and famine and distress is going to continue.
Earthquakes.
What else can I say there? We've had record every year. It's another record of earthquakes, tremors. And now we're seeing what's called these swarms. For instance, just recently, the San Andreas fault line. I mean, Southern California, once again, and we've heard so much about how that could just break off into the ocean. There's actually now seismologists that are saying that literally San Diego will just lift up and shift 45 degrees into the ocean. You've got Mount Hood up in Oregon. We've had volcanoes erupting up in Iceland and the Congo and Indonesia, and Italy is always in a dangerous situation. We're going to see more and more and more of these earthquakes and volcanic activity. This is all part of part of it, I think, is, you know, when the Bible says that the heavens will be shaking, I look at Planet X or a binary system, whatever you want to call it. You can study some of the ancient texts, the Sumerians. Emmanuel Velikovsky wrote a book called Worlds in Collision that talks about the events that happened. The Bible tells us things have happened before the last time that the Planet X or the binary system may be passed by. So I think this is all part, again, of the prophecies of God giving us warnings of the things to come. Earthquakes certainly is one.
Our next one, pole change. You mentioned it a little bit.
You know something? There's no doubt about this. The poles are shifting. It's happened before in our existence. We've even confined where there's lost civilizations, probably ancient civilizations, were probably wiped out due to pole shifts, pole changes that is affecting the planet. Here we go again, as the Earth once again is seeing its magnetic shield shifting. And in the Bible, it tells us, in the book of Isaiah, chapter 24, verse 1, the Bible said, "Behold, the Lord maketh the earth empty, and maketh it waste, and turneth it upside down, and scattereth abroad the inhabitants thereof." So, George, again, science is confirming prophecy. So I think it's better to be able to say, why are these things happening? Well, we've got some proof scientifically. We've got prophecy. Instead of us saying, I don't know. I don't understand. Maybe I should jump on an a spaceship with Elon Musk. No. Okay. You don't have to leave the planet. But you do have to prepare for what the planet's going to go through and what we're all going to go through in these times of great tribulation.
Next up, the Day of Darkness. What is that?
You know, the Day of Darkness, when you look at a solar eclipse, that's one thing. But the Bible talks about the sun being darkened, the moon turning to blood, the Day of Darkness, gloominess, the Day of Clouds, thick darkness. I really believe it was spread upon the mountains. That this is found in Joel chapter 2. When you start to look at these massive volcanic eruptions, these super volcanoes that scientists have discovered, and they're talking more and more about them all the time. When these things erupt, they can create a what's called a winter, a real dark winter, where the earth will be cooled. the darkness, the ash, gloominess. The sun doesn't come through near enough. And this will affect, you know, this is how you have the dust bowls, this is how you have unbelievable straight-line winds and darkness and famine all kind of coincide with this. And this is coming. It's not really one day, it's days of darkness, in my opinion. But it's a figure of speech that I think the prophet Joel uses, a time of great despair. Even the Bible talks about Jacob's troubles, or the Bible, the book of Revelation, tribulation period in the book of Revelation. So I think that this great darkness will come from a massive super volcano eruption.
Oh, well, that's not cool.
And hopefully, you know, I think that when this happens, people will look at this scripture and say, oh my, this is what he meant.
Animal die-offs.
George, we've had more animals die in the last 10 years. Dead birds, dead fish, dead cows. I mean, there is the statistics on the fish die-off and the cattle falling over dead and the sheep and the goats and the llamas. And I've been studying this for 11 years, and the Bible tells us in the book of Hosea, it tells us that because there's no truth, there's no mercy, there's no knowledge of God in the land, and because of the swearing, the lying, the killing, the stealing, and committing adultery, the blood's going to touch blood, it's going to break out, and we're going to, all of a sudden, the land's going to languish. The earth is going to be in turmoil, and we're going to see that with the beasts of the field, the fish of the sea, the fowls of the air are going to die. And statistically, nothing even close to what we've witnessed the last 10 years. It's not stopping. It will not stop. I remember being interviewed by CNN 11 years ago when I did a YouTube video called Dead Birds, Dead Fish, Dead Cows, Now What? And when I was interviewed, they said, do you really believe this is prophecy? I said, absolutely. And I'll prove it to you in the scripture. But check back with me 10 years from now. You'll see it doesn't end. It won't end. You can change the carbon footprint. We can do all of the things we can to make clean energy. You're not going to stop the prophecy. And it's been 10 years. I'm still waiting for that phone call. But the animals are dying everywhere.
Yep, they sure are. So now, you touched on this somewhat, signs in the sun, moon, and stars.
When you look at the, as we said, again, I think God is saying, mankind, George, has always looked up into the heavens. You know, from the beginning of man on the earth, and we're like, what's out there? What's up there? Give me a sign. You've heard people say that. God says, okay, I'll put in something into rhythm. I'll put into motion a plan for you so that when you see these extraordinary things, you'll know that you're living in extraordinary times. Now, Jesus said in one scripture, he said, there will be great signs and fearful sights in the heavens. This is found in Luke chapter 21. I think it's verses 10 and 11. And there's even scripture that says there will be signs in the sun, the moon, the stars. And upon the earth, distress of nations. Okay, so the heavens, you'll see signs. And then on the earth, you'll see distress of nations with confusion or perplexity. The sea and the waves will be roaring. We're breaking records every year, George, on typhoons, hurricanes, cyclones. They're off the charts. And we keep trying to figure out, why do these, how can we keep breaking records on earthquakes, volcanoes, hurricanes, cyclones, monsoons, typhoons, baboons, pontoons, blood moons? I mean, how do you keep breaking every record every year?
Every year.
Yeah, we're getting incredible signals, if you will, from the heavens that we have to take a look at ourselves internally now. Say, okay, what kind of a person am I? Do I treat my neighbor like I want to be treated? Have I got my act together? And I think God, ultimately, his mercy, his grace, gives us this opportunity to reflect within ourselves what we're seeing. And a lot of times we don't see our own faults. We see everybody else's. Well, now we're seeing, everyone is seeing the universe itself volatile, inconsistently having massive changes. And maybe we should take a look at ourselves and ask ourselves, am I the person I need to be during the times that we're in? Because certainly it's extraordinary. We can study history and look at now. There's nothing like it ever has happened before like this. Not all of these events at the same time.
Paul, when we come back, I want to talk about three more areas of the apocalypse: hail, wildfires, and these asteroids. And then we'll take phone calls with you on Coast to Coast AM.
Never miss a detail on a show or a guest. Sign up for the Coast Zone email newsletter, available for free at coasttocoastam.com.
Cloth layers. Together we can end this pandemic. Visit COVID-19.ca.gov today to learn more. Brought to you by the Center at Sierra Health Foundation.
If you or your family have been financially impacted by COVID-19, this pandemic is not your fault. And new California laws have been passed to help.
That's right. If you've fallen behind on your mortgage or run up credit card or business debt, please listen carefully.
Our friends at Oak Tree Law know every letter of the new laws. And just listen to these real examples of how they've helped our listeners.
A nurse from Torrance had her hours cut due to COVID-19. She was hit with medical issues of her own, racked up $160,000 in debt, and fell behind on her mortgage. With this new law, she was able to get current on her mortgage and eliminate the bad debt.
Here's a story about a real estate agent and her husband in Pasadena. Their income stopped when the pandemic hit. Their second mortgage was threatening to foreclose, and they had $75,000 in credit card and business debt. This new law allowed them to protect their home and eliminate the debt.
This pandemic has affected us all, but there is life-changing help available with one absolutely free call to Oak Tree Law.
800-542-2949, 800-542-2949, or visit OakTreeLaw.com.
Getting families vaccinated against COVID-19 is an important step to bringing back joy for all of us. That's within reach now that the Pfizer vaccine is proven safe and effective for those 12 and older. This is the same vaccine millions of Californians have already gotten. California is even adding new vaccine clinics specifically for young people. Together, we can end the pandemic. Visit VaccinateAll58.com or call 833-422-4255. To learn more.
You can listen to KFI everywhere, like you haven't noticed. KFI AM 640 Los Angeles, Orange County.
And KOST HD2.
It's 5 a.m. What did you miss?
It's time for Wake Up Call with Jennifer Jones Lee.
Wow. It's a busy morning. Then I can look in the file and see all the stories that we're covering today, and I know that if it goes on to a separate page, better get right to it. So that's what we'll do. Here's what's just ahead on your wake-up call for this Thursday. The mask rules for when the state fully reopens next week have been clarified. LA County Sheriff Dean Nueva says, I am not going anywhere, even though a lot of county officials would like him to. And a Marine general has been removed from his position over a training accident that killed 9.